Hello and welcome to PC World. I am Hayden Dingman and I am here with Adam Patrick Murray like usual.
Hey, that's me. Hi, we're going to play some video games.
Yeah, two video games today actually.
Sweet.
We're going to play some Forza 7 and some Project Cars 2. Talk a little bit about the differences and similarities.
I drive cars in real life. Is it like this?
Sort of. More than Forza Horizon, probably.
Does it have a 2007 Honda Civic in this one?
I don't know about 2007, but it probably has a Honda Civic in it.
Sweet.
So yeah, we're going to jump into just a career race. I don't want to do anything fancy, necessarily. Yeah. And I'm driving this crappy little hot hatch.
Yeah. Also, look at your VIP character. Wow.
Yeah, so, I mean...
That's nice looking.
So we talked about this a little bit on The Full Nerd, but... There are loot crates in this game, or prize crates, as they call them.
How many can I buy if I wanted to?
You can buy a lot. we can buy one right now, actually. We can show you what it's like to open a Forza 7 loot crate.
I hope the animation is really good.
This has been pretty controversial, because what we'll get out of here, you can see this is called a mods crate, because what we're going to get out of it is a thing called a mod. In this case,
I'm sorry, that animation wasn't very...
Yeah, it's not amazing. So yeah, we can put these... Basically, what you do is you slot them into your mod slots in this screen. Hold on, we're going to get our introduction to the track here.
Oh, good. Where is this?
I would assume Italy. I don't know.
Oh, sweet. Okay.
So yeah, what we do over here, we have this mods thing... where we can slot in our different mods. And so like in this race, if we perform two good corners, we get extra money out of it.
Okay.
We also have the stability management turned off for this race to get money.
But that's a card?
Yes. So in the old Forzas, you would just turn off the assists as you felt like it. And so, like, turning off the racing line, for instance, would net you some amount of credits every race.
I always hated racing lines.
I like the braking line, personally, because I'm very bad at judging corners in these sorts of games. But, yeah, either way, like, you could turn them off, you know, to suit your own purposes, and then they would reward you for doing that. In this one, there is no reward for turning off any of the assists. They just... put it in these cards instead.
So they just expect you to play awesome?
Yeah, I guess. Like, I don't know. It seems kind of weird that they would not tie the difficulty to anything, but and let's see if we can actually not spin out. Nope.
Whoa! Nice. This is how I drive in real life.
Yeah, this is definitely how I drive.
That's actually a really cool steering wheel. Can you buy new steering wheels?
No, you cannot. Oh. That would be a much better thing to put in those loot crates.
we should also say you're actually racing on a wheel.
I am. We are using a Logitech G29. One of the interesting things about this wheel is it is actually a PS4 wheel. I think the corresponding Xbox wheel is like a 920. I think that's the way they did their numbering.
Okay.
Yeah, we're using the PS4 wheel. It works fine. The only thing that it doesn't do is it doesn't tell you, because this is an Xbox game, it doesn't map any of the keys with the icons that they correspond to.
You just have to remember what's what.
Yeah, there's been a lot of like feeling it for me. Like the start button is on like a really weird, it's on the R2 button on the actual PlayStation wheel, which is a very weird place to put it. We don't have this problem in Project Cars, which is like an actual multi-platform, like they expect you to use a PS4 wheel in it. There, the start button is actually the start button, which you would expect. So
that makes sense.
I don't know. I don't know. It's weird they would include support for it, but only like this, you know, half-ass support. But
you're really slamming in those corners.
Oh yeah!
Whoa,
oh
yeah!
Yeah.
Oh, perfect.
It's very hard to play this game while talking.
It's okay. This is exactly how I would play this game.
This is a good example of like when they tell you not to have a passenger in your car because you'll be distracted. This is a good example of that right here.
He's just fussing with your GPS, don't worry.
Yeah, exactly. It also doesn't help that we have a mic obstructing half my view right now.
Complaining.
But yeah, I mean, part
excuses.
Of this is that I'm not going to make any bones about it. I'm definitely an arcade racer. And have been for my entire life. I definitely,
same for me.
Horizon is my Forza of choice.
Yeah.
And I'll play this and I can do okay, but
it's beautiful.
Yeah, it is very pretty.
Especially on the PC.
It's also a little more cartoony. We're dead. This is the end
sand.
For us.
No.
Oh god.
No.
You'll see when we move over to Project Cars, the graphics there I think are a little crisper, and the field of view is a lot better.
Huh.
Yeah, we dropped back like 20 positions in that. Yeah, I actually think I prefer the Project Cars graphics a little more.
Okay.
There's something about Forza. It's like a little, like all the edges are a little soft, and it's like a little.
Huh.
Okay. I don't know, just a little more cartoony.
What about the weather effects and stuff like that?
I really like the weather here, especially. So this is the first one that has like the rain affects the race. So
like it actually puddles on the ground.
Yeah,
correct?
So you can hydroplane in this if it starts raining.
That was never in a Forza before.
No,
wow.
I'm pretty sure this is the first one where they made that a thing.
Wow.
And also so there's a Dubai track that they showed off in the demo, I think.
Yeah, I played that in the demo.
So there's like a whole area in the backside of that where there's sand blowing across the track. And that sand actually affects your traction also, which is new to the series.
I didn't notice that. I must have had all the assists on.
yeah, I should have probably just turned all the assists on for this race instead of embarrassing myself with this.
This
kind
of fun.
Horrible turns.
It actually makes me tense up when you go into a turn, like almost like I'm your. What was that arcade game, Lucky and Wild? Where like
I don't know.
The one guy drove and the other one just shot.
I don't know.
You never played that one.
No.
Oh, I love that one in the arcade.
I'm liking so like. That's we should talk about the actual game part of this, I think. I'm actually enjoying the racing in Forza quite a bit as somebody who more is on the arcade racing side of things. I think that Forza is like a little more approachable, which you wouldn't know from watching this video and watching me like slam into corners and stuff.
Like compared to Project Cars.
Yeah, compared to Project Cars, which when we move over to that, you'll see like if you think I'm bad on this right now, you should wait until we get over there. Yeah,
yeah, stay with us.
We should also show off. I still have the rewind on, so I could have been doing this the whole time, too.
Oh, whatever. Do you have rewind in Project Cars?
No, you don't have rewind in Project Cars, which is why you just end up spinning out all the time. here, you can at least, like, correct yourself. I think that because of the rewind, because of the assists, and just because of the driving model in general, I feel like this is a little more approachable. The cars seem to have more traction in Forza, no matter what. Like, you could turn all the assists off and it still feels like you have more traction than playing Project Cars with all the assists on. I was telling you, I was racing the other night in Project Cars and I was doing laps for like an hour just trying to nail a lap without spinning out on at least one corner, because especially some of the mid-tier cars, like once you get into the very high-end cars in Project Cars, you can keep the traction around the corners a lot better because those cars are built for performance. But like especially trying to race like sedans or something in Project Cars, anything that's like a mid-tier car, I feel like I was just constantly having problems.
So I've never played Project Cars 2 or the first one. It's supposed to be like the most simmiest racing sim out there. Is that what they're hanging
about,
their head on?
I don't know about that. They are like a very simmy racer, though. They're up there with Assetto Corsa and iRacing for the like hardcore PC sim crowd.
But definitely more than this.
Same corner again. definitely more than Forza. People call Forza like sim light or like arcade sim, which I think they usually say in a derogatory way.
Probably.
But like, I don't know, for me personally, like this is a lot friendlier. Like I can play Forza and have a good time. I can play Project Cars and have a good time. But like a lot of Project Cars is actually like getting better at driving. I bet the skills that you would learn in like a Project Cars type sim are a lot more applicable to like the real cars that you
really?
Would drive.
Huh.
Whereas like this, like there's, you know, you focus on cornering.
Still
and,
more of a game.
Yeah. Like, so like for instance, you know, we just ran into that car. Or like we've gone off track a couple of times in this race. Yeah. And in Project Cars, like they just disqualify your time, which from what I understand, my girlfriend's stepdad races as a hobby.
Nice.
And from what I understand, that's more realistic. Like he's gotten dismissed from, we're about to finish this race.
Woo-hoo!
Fourth,
nice.
Yeah, not too bad considering we came back from 22nd at one point. he races as a hobby, and from what I understand, like he bumped another car at one point, and like both those cars got thrown out of the race.
Wow.
So from what I understand, that's like more accurate to real life racing, but like it's not necessarily fun. Like it's not cool to just like, oh great, like your time is just thrown out and you got disqualified or whatever. So yeah, I don't know.
Like, well, but are people coming to this for fun?
I don't know. It's hard to know like what the audience really is. Like for me, I'm just playing these for fun. I just want to like have a good time racing.
Yeah. I just like how like I always come to these to see like how pretty they are.
Yeah. You know,
they're always
that too.
Like graphical showcases, and you're just like, wow, this is.
But especially like
beautiful.
the sim crowd, like I don't know what they would want out of it, and like maybe they really want to like just be thrown out for contact or whatever. But that's just not like that's not why I'm here. I'm here for like something that gives me that feeling of like this is more realistic than like Horizon. Horizon is just like goofy,
yeah, oh,
right?
Yeah.
Like Horizon.
Oh, yeah.
This is like more like an actual race, and it gives me that feeling of like, okay, I got to work on my corners, I got to work on like passing and stuff like that. But without like the penalty of just like, hey, you messed up one time and like that's it, and now you're kind of done for the next hour.
It seems a little harsh.
Just before we quit out here and move over to Project Cars where we can continue this conversation, we did just level up, which we can show off the collection score I was telling you about earlier.
Yes.
So
the collectors.
This is a new thing for Forza 7. Instead of just buying the cars you want, you actually have to level up your car collection over time. So you can see when we go to buy this, it says collector score plus 160.
That's such a weird progression.
And so we'll buy this car because...
awesome car.
Yeah, why not?
That at least is an awesome car. But you're saying most of the time you just have to buy cars just arbitrarily just so you get your collector score.
Yeah, so... here we go. So now we reached collection tier 4, which means that now we can buy the fourth tier of cars.
Huh.
And we'll be able to see that. I can jump into that in a second.
Does that... But that's tied to how many cars you have?
Yeah, it's tied to how many you already own.
Not
so.
Like off of some sort of like skill tree number isn't the four in the corner
is
different?
Yeah, so we own enough cars to score 4,050 out of the next tier is at 8,000.
Oh, that's the tier number. Oh, okay.
Yeah, so we own, like for instance, this Cadillac Limo.
Nice.
And this Chevy
Plymouth
Nova.
GTX.
this 66 Corvette.
Mm-hmm. The Fast and the Furious, Brandon.
70 Challenger. We own quite a few of these. Some of these came because I was a VIP. So, like, if you played Horizon and Horizon 2 and all that, they give you some stuff. Having played those games.
Okay.
You can see, like, this is the top tier, I think. I'm pretty sure 5 is the top tier.
Oh, so you're almost there.
I'm getting there. The Veyron is up here. I can't spot it right now, but, like, so most of the cars that, like, people think of when they think of racing games are up in this top tier somewhere.
Nice.
So, the Venom. And Koenigsegg's and
McLaren P1.
All those are up in this top tier. And like normally what you would do you would just save all your money for the whole game.
Yeah,
to get
of
up
course.
There. But this game doesn't let you do that. You have to burn quite a bit to like buy some of these crappy cars that you don't want. So really,
if you gave them real money to get fake money, then you can buy as many cars as you want. To then unlock the tier?
Yeah.
It has nothing to do with your racing ability?
Yeah, I don't know how it's going to work. I don't know if they're going to exchange loot boxes for real money in box form. Or like you can also buy loot boxes that have cars in them. So we haven't done that here. But
what happens if the car tied to your level? Or can you unlock a car and be like, oh, you can't drive it yet because you're not tier 5?
No, you can drive anything you get. So I have a few cars already in the top categories because they have these...
Okay.
They have showcase races like in Horizon where you know they're like race this. Like the Porsche is the big one for this because they announced that car alongside this game or whatever. So there is a showcase that's like 20 years of Porsche or something where you have to pass all of, I think it's in the first thing here. No, I guess not. But there are these showcase races at the bottom of each thing. So like, I haven't finished this one yet because it's crazy. Yeah, this is the passing challenge with this Porsche 918. And so when you finish these, you get the car that you used in it. Okay. And those cars are usually in that, like those top two tiers, either tier four or tier five. So like, we can pull this up real quick.
So if it's awarded to you, you can drive it.
Yeah, you can drive it.
You can't buy it until
exactly.
You're in a
and so
tier.
Like this car, like obviously, is a fancy
a cool car.
Little car.
It's a cool car.
So we couldn't buy that yet, but we can use it once we finish this race. But yeah, let's jump over to Project Cars. We can show that off real quick, and we'll be right back. Okay, we are back.
We're back.
Well, we didn't really disappear for you at home, but yeah, this is Project Cars. We've jumped over.
I gotta say, first thing, the music. It's not very fun.
Very dire.
Yeah. It's like, you're going to die out there.
So yeah, we're going to jump into a custom race because one of the things that I don't like about Project Cars is the career mode. Mm-hmm. I haven't even made it very far into it.
Why? What's wrong with it?
So you end up signing into a specific like event class every time.
Okay.
And then as you move up, you unlock more event classes. But like a lot of the early event classes are like go-karts and
what?
And like C-tier, like really low-tier stuff that it's more realistic, but yeah. I don't necessarily enjoy driving
it,
especially in Project Cars where the handling is like very twitchy already. trying to drive a go-kart in this is a nightmare.
Okay.
And we're going to jump down to a different course just so I don't spin out quite as often.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I mean, we can go in and we can tweak the rules and regulations. So like, that's what I was talking about with the getting penalties for running into people and stuff.
Okay. You can turn that off.
Yeah, we can jump in here and turn that off if we want, but we'll leave it on.
Oh, leave it on.
We can also change all of the race settings. So we can change it to like summer. We can change the exact date in the summer.
Why? Why?
Because the lighting will be different.
Oh.
So like, we can change
the moon
it to
is waxing or waning.
Yeah, exactly. So we can change it to what's today, the 6th?
Yes.
Yeah, so we can change it to today. We can pretend that we got off work at like 6 o'clock, and that's when we're gonna go drive.
I'm glad you can count military time.
I it's I don't know. It's pretty nice outside today, but we can like put
it's
in
really
some.
Nice. We can oh, roll
it,
the dice.
We
dude.
Can make it foggy like normal San Francisco
yeah,
weather.
There you go.
And then we can go ahead and start. Oh, I didn't check the options.
What kind of options?
This might be running in 4K.
Oh, crap.
It's fine. Yeah, it's fine. Cool.
Yeah,
okay.
Well, it's just like drop ramp.
So yeah, we got here. One of the things I like about this game is they have a thing called the race engineer.
Okay. So like your pit boss?
Yeah. So in Forza, you have to do all the tuning by hand if you want to, like, you know, correct understeer or something like that.
Okay.
Nice thing about Project Cars is you can go in and, like, if you know it's a problem with understeer, like, I can tell you what the problem with the car is by driving it, but I don't necessarily know what I have to change. Here, I can just say, like, in plain English, the car is turning too much in corners. And then they say, okay, when? Is it, like, while it's going through the corner? Is it when you're coming out of the corner? You can say that.
But
and
is,
then
is this more
say,
realistic?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, I guess if
you
have like a mechanic, yeah, like
you
have a mechanic, that's the conceit here. And so he'll just say like, hey, I'll soften the rear anti-roll bar so that this isn't so much of a problem anymore.
Huh.
And like, that to me is like one of those big barriers to sim racers usually is like knowing what all of the adjustments do. And once you've played a few of them, like, you start to understand. But I think it's really cool that they've built in, like, hey, you can just, like, go in here. Like, oh, I'm having a problem with braking. I'm not stopping in time. And they'll just, like, okay, we'll increase the brake pressure.
But you don't have to use the race engineer. You can go in.
Yep, oh, okay. You can go in and just, like, change everything in these crazy menus.
Okay. But that is interesting, though.
But, like, I think it's nice to just have a thing that's a little more approachable for people, especially so we're not going to do that here. Usually we would do a qualifying lap before we even get into the race, and actually you can do like a 30-minute practice before you get into the race too.
Wow,
to really like
minutes.
Get the oh my god we're gonna die already to really like get the feel of the track down. And so, like, yeah, it's much more simmy. I actually missed the qualifying when I go back to...
Well, you're not in the cockpit.
We lap time invalidated already. Oh, yeah, we're not in the cockpit. Here, we'll change.
There he is.
I actually missed the qualifying laps when I go back to Forza, because Forza, you just like this. You always start in the rear position and you have to make up time the whole time.
Huh. Interesting.
In Project Cars, like, if you're a good racer, you can just start in first place and just run first place the whole time.
Nice.
I'm not that good of a racer. And in fact, it's a miracle that we haven't spun out yet.
Yeah, you're doing really good.
This is why I chose to drive this Aventador, because the traction is really good. It's a bit of a cheat on my part, but I'm one of the things I really like about this game actually is the force feedback is a lot stronger than Forza. In Forza, I have the force feedback turned up all the way, and I still feel like it's pretty loose most of the time.
Okay.
It's more of a suggestion most of the time of like what a real racing wheel would feel like.
Huh.
In this, it's like
every single
like turn, you can feel the force feedback fighting against you, which I think is,
that's fun.
For me, I prefer that. Some people might not, because it's like technically force feedback is supposed to be more of like a suggestion. There goes our lap time.
Whoops.
There goes our hundreds
perfect
of thousands
lap.
Of dollars for this vehicle. And
oh, look at your tire pressure. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
It's a little low on the back right.
Well, we haven't been doing enough drifting.
Wait, what was that?
That was our race. We did a nice one lap race.
Oh, okay. I was about to say, I was like, uh-oh, what happened?
We'll jump over. We'll do the same race in the daytime now with the light better.
Okay.
Just to show the difference. Let's turn that heavy fog off. Maybe show some light rain. That'll be fun.
Why not?
And we'll just do two laps this time.
Yeah.
Just keep it going a little bit longer.
I have faith in you. How many loot boxes can I buy in this game?
So yeah, that's one of the things there's no loot boxes in Project Cars, first of all. Second of all,
what?
All the cars are just available from the get-go. You don't have to like do this,
you're
like
lying.
Buy a car thing. All the tracks are available from
but
the get-go.
But how am I going to progress?
You just get better, I guess. that's the thing. I don't think that this is necessarily the most realistic sim. And remember, I'm not a great judge of that because I'm not like a heavy sim racer person.
Me
but
neither.
From what I've played of Assetto Corsa and iRacing, like both of those are more simmy than this in terms of just certain aspects of how the cars handle. Especially those mid-tier cars, I think, are a little slippery in Project Cars 2 compared to what they would be normally. This is definitely more simmy than Forza, from like the way that the cars handle to the way that the tracks feel. The way that this rain feels, for instance, is very scary in Project Cars 2. I like the graphics look of it. As I said, I think this is a little more realistic. The cars especially look a little nicer than Forza.
What about damage modeling and stuff?
I think is a little better here, especially it's the tire modeling that I think is better, especially compared to Project Cars 1, where the tire modeling was a big point of complaint.
Really?
There's some problems.
Like it didn't look rubbery enough?
Yeah, it's not the way it looked. It was more the
texture, the
way it
feel?
Handled.
Oh, okay.
There are some problems here with, from what I've read, the tires not heating up correctly if you do very long races. But as you can tell, I'm not somebody who's doing very long races, so it doesn't matter to me most of the time. But yeah, I've enjoyed my time with this game, and it is very simmy in that all of those cars are unlocked from the start. Like, you can just jump in, and if you want to just drive an Aventador around every track in the game, like, you can do that. Oh, God, here we go. This is our ending
really
right here.
Really lost it. Really lost it. No. Boom.
Luckily, we can just...
Hey, look at those guys. They didn't even flinch. Like,
luckily,
yeah.
We just teleport back onto the track.
Oh, that's realistic.
But yeah, I think that in general, like, the way that the progression is built in this, there isn't really one. Uh-huh. There is in the career mode, but outside of that, there's not, like, you're not buying cars or anything.
Huh.
I think that is definitely more in line with, like, Sims. Like, if you play Flight Sims, you're not, like, unlocking new planes to fly over time. You're just flying planes.
Yeah, it makes sense.
But yeah, I've really enjoyed my time with the game, and it's nice that there isn't all of that stuff around it the way that Forza has, where you're like, now I gotta buy these loot boxes, and oh my god, we're really... Now I gotta buy these loot boxes, and now I gotta, you know, spend all this money on this car, and
but you don't want just to get a car, you do want.
Yeah, those aspects are very gamey, I guess, but they're not really like what I think people would want from a hardcore sim. On the other hand, as I said, like coming from an arcade standpoint, mm-hmm. like coming from a Forza Horizon fan standpoint,
Burnout Paradise.
This game, like playing this game for hours and hours the other day, it's made me better slightly at like racing and understanding how the physics of a car works and stuff, but uh-huh. It also is like very much a sim. Like it is just brutal to play. I almost
so you're
wanna,
saying
like,
it's not fun.
It's fun in a different way. Like it's fun to master a car and to master a track, but like it's not a game that you just like zone out and play for a couple of hours. Like it is a very active, like you have to be paying attention.
You have to practice.
You have to it's funny because they put that 30-minute practice mode and then or 30-minute practice session and then like 15-minute qualifying on there.
Uh-huh.
And so like every single race you're like taking an hour
just
to like
race.
Yeah, go through one race, and you like think like, nah, I don't need that. Like I remember like jumping into Project Cars 1 and then jumping into this for the first time after like 2 years away and just being like, I don't need the qualifying, like I don't need the practice, whatever. And then you just are terrible. Like you take your first lap and you spin out on every corner because you don't know what anything does. I really think that like Forza in that regard is much better at just like
throwing
you
in.
We're a sim sorta. Like you were more simmy than like your average Burnout or Forza or whatever, Forza Horizon game. But it still is like a game that you can just like hang out, have a good time, drink a beer while you're playing. Project Cars 2 is like it's work, man.
I can imagine
wrestling this car around the track.
Well, then you mentioned this has VR support, correct?
Yes, this does have VR support, which Forza does not. So that's another reason to maybe jump into this instead.
I played some Dirt Rally in Oculus, and that was fun. It wasn't great.
Yeah, from what I understand, as far as VR racing goes, Project Cars is up there with like the best implementation.
Nice.
So definitely worth checking out. In fact, I kind of want to check it out this weekend now that the releases have slowed down a bit for just a second.
For a second.
I kind of want to check it out this weekend and do some racing because I do think it's really cool to be able to just look around in the cockpit, especially like trying. It's really hard not to make contact with other cars when like the other cars are on either side of you and you can't tell that they're there.
So if they hit you, you get disqualified?
Yeah,
if you mess it up. That doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, it's kind of brutal. So, as I said, Project Cars, very realistic, but, like, I don't know if that's necessarily... If you're just like, I want a fun racing game, I don't know if that's what you should go for.
Okay, I'll probably skip Project Cars.
But it is, like, I do have to give them props. I think that especially some of those higher-end cars, the handling is really good.
Mm-hmm.
The force feedback wheel in this is much better. It's nice to not be nickeled and dimed and just be able to jump into a nice car right off the bat, not have somebody tell you like, oh, hey, you have to wait to drive something cool. Like you have to put in your dues on this 55 box car.
Wait, but where's your avatar with your cool VIP outfit?
I don't have any
outfit,
but like there are a bunch of cars in here. You were talking about Hondas earlier. So there's your Civic
there
Coupe.
We go. Oh, there we go. That's not the one
I got
have.
A bunch of Ferraris,
nice.
Bunch of BMWs. I think they have a Mini in here.
But the support for Project Cars 1 was pretty good. So, I mean, they're going to be... or what?
It was okay. Yeah. They kind of abandoned Project Cars 1 kind of early to make Project Cars 2, which I think was very controversial at the time.
Yeah.
I don't know how many people are still angry about it, but I do remember that being a thing at the time. I also like how on these cars they have the difficulty down at the nice. Bottom, so
we
can see how bad some of them are.
Okay.
We should drive that guy.
Yeah, let's do it.
But yeah, this is our quick breakdown. As I said, from two arcade racing fans.
Yeah.
Of Forza 7 Project Cars 2. We didn't do too bad. I made it around the track at least.
You didn't. Yeah.
Luckily,
I didn't get to try. So.
It's been interesting to me. It's definitely been fun getting better. It's the first time that I've, especially like having Forza, having that be like a more approachable sim instead of like these other hardcore racing sims on the PC. It's nice having Forza on the PC because it's the first time in a while that I've really like, I'm gonna sit down and like actually try and get better at racing games. Whereas like Project Cars 2, I jump in and I play it for a couple hours and I like have a good time, but then at the end I just feel like very drained. It's just a lot of work.
You need an arcade racer to cleanse your palate.
Yeah, exactly. I need that Forza Horizon 4. We're still a year out from that. I hope you guys had a good time watching. We will be back pretty soon with tons of games. It is October, so lots of stuff coming out.
Yes.
And we'll see you soon.
Thank you, Hayden.
Yeah, thanks, Adam. Bye.